I've always been very skeptical when it comes to anything ghost-related. I know there's something other than us human spirits and whatnot, but until that night, I'd never experienced anything that'd leave me to believe otherwise. My family takes a trip to Colorado every year. We tend to stay in the smaller cities for the fishing and hiking aspects, avoiding lots of crowds and touristy spots. Since the first time we decided to start taking these trips, we found a very cute, quaint set of log cabins right on the Dolores River. Mind you, Dolores has a population of about 1,000 people, so it's quite small. Anyways, it was our second time staying in these little cabins and we'd gotten to know the owner very well. She took us on a 4-hour drive through the mountains, cooked us dinner and became a great friend to our whole family. That night, my mom, dad, brother and I hit the hay around 10 p.m. We were absolutely exhausted. I laid in bed, thinking I was absolutely about to sack the fuck out, but I literally could not close my eyes. My mom and my dad shared the king-size bed across the room and my brother laid in a twin at the opposite side, and I got the bunk bed. My body was drained, but for some odd reason, I could not get myself to fall asleep. I fucking tossed and turned for over 5 hours, feeling like somebody or something was among us in the room. You know when you just get that creepy-ass feeling? Yeah, I felt that way for hours on end. I tried to bury myself in my phone on various social media apps, but something kept drawing my attention to the stair in the corner. There was one light left downstairs, so the staircase was barely lit. Every time I felt myself about to look over, I was convinced I'd see something. To my surprise, I hadn't seen a damn thing. It was around 5:30 a.m. and I'd finally settled down, or so I thought. I rolled over, and forced myself to close my eyes. I was drifting off into one hell of a good sleep until my eyes sprung open. I felt my whole body roll over without my permission. Once I was flipped over, I got that fucking urge to look towards that stupid staircase. But this time, I saw something. It wasn't scary, so to speak, but it definitely wasn't comforting. The figure had long, dark, stringy hair. She was quite pale but obviously beautiful. She had a small frame but below the waist wasn't visible, it just floated. I felt my body shiver but I said fuck it, and got up. As I approached the figure, she started to fade. I finally got up close to her and she just smiled. I stared at her for as long as I could until she disappeared. After that, I was fucking shook. I couldn't stop thinking about who she was or what she wanted with me. Why was I the only one that could feel her presence? The next morning, I told my mom, dad, and brother about the situation. They laughed and thought I was just fucking crazy or drunk off my ass. But I knew I had seen something real. The owner of the cabins made her way over to us as we enjoyed a nice breakfast by the river. As we all started talking, my mom decided to relay my experience to her. As my mom was talking, the sweet lady started to tear up. I stopped my mom and asked her what was wrong. She then told us that her mother had died in that cabin years ago. She said that sometimes she still comes to visit, just to make friends. She had long, dark, stringy hair and very pale skin. She was simply just coming to say hi, thanking us for enjoying her cabin that she built. I haven't seen her since. This content was provided by Angelo Tricar.